RBM.
Hello and welcome to the RBM Quick Start Guide. My name is Werner and in this video I will show you the basic steps that are needed to bring RBM to your single board computer, or SBC for short. Starting from grabbing the necessary tools and downloads and finishing with connecting via SSH. To get an idea what RBM is all about, I recommend watching Nico D's video as he covers that. I'll leave a link in the info box. You need, obviously, a development board which is supported by RBM. To check this, simply go to their download page and look for your board in the list. And no, Raspberry Pis are not supported and never will. Use Raspbian for that. The reason is also covered in Nico D's video. Next, you need a microSD card, and if your computer does not have a built-in reader device, you need such a thing as well. Your SD card should have 8 GB of space at least. Also, using an A2 rated card can save you quite some time when writing the image to the card, and it will provide better performance in general. Then you need your PC or laptop running any Linux distribution, but a less well-known alternative operating system like macOS or Windows will do the job as well. Because I'm an evil person, I go for Windows. Last but not least, a power cable, in my case, an USB to barrel plug adapter, and a patch cable to connect your board to your router, switch or whatever. As for the software part, we need to download two things, RBM itself and an SD card writer tool. Let's go for RBM first. Like earlier in this video, go to rbm.com and click on download. Select your board and choose your favorite flavor. The other item we need is the recommended SD card writer tool. Some may argue that they simply could use DD to write the image to the SD card. While this is technically correct, keep in mind that there will be no verification that the data has been written correctly. That is why I highly recommend to use the tool I show you, as it verifies the written data afterwards. This will save you from headache and maybe even major pain in the butt as well. Anyway, either use your favorite search engine and search for a USB imager, or follow the link I also put in the description below. Grab a version that fits your computer's running system. For the unlikely case that USB imager fails on you, search for Berliner Etcher and use this tool instead. Put the SD card in your reader and fire up USB imager. It might be necessary to start the tool with root or admin permission or whatever the privileged user on your system may be called. Select the image as well as the SD card device if it is not detected automatically. Click on write and let it finish. Well, up to this point, that was basically the most difficult part to make RBM work. Remove the SD card from your reader device and put it into your board, then connect it to its rated input voltage. Just as a side note, keep in mind it is actually not recommended to power SBCs via micro-USB, as this, depending on the load, can cause weird behavior due to voltage drops. You can find tons of information on that in the RBM forums. I will leave you a link in the description below. If possible, power your board via a DC barrel plug or GPIO pins. As I use an Orange Pi 1 for this demonstration, I use the barrel plug. Do not connect power before having the SD card inserted, as, if you haven't tried and already realized, it won't work. Also connect your patch cable. This can be done anytime. RBM comes shipped with DHCP enabled by default, and it will ask your home router for an IP address once it's fully booted up. So, while the board is starting, navigate to your router's interface and list the devices that are connected to your local area network at the moment. Don't worry if the SBC is not listed already, since the first boot may take longer than usual, which is normal. Simply be patient. As soon as the board is listed, note its IP address and fire up your favorite SSH client. Type in its address and connect. For login, use the username root and the password 1234. You now will be asked to change the default password. Choose something strong. That was pretty much it. Easy, right? You now can start to customize your system or do whatever you plan to do with it. But before ending this video, I would like to mention two things that might become important while using your board. The first and more important thing is the RBM monitor tool. While it is useful to show clock speeds and temperatures of your chip, its major purpose is providing debug information which you need to provide when raising an issue on forums. When used with the parameter -u, It will collect various information about the board like bootlogs, installed system packages, versions, and more to upload them to a paste service. Simply give it a try. Type Armbian Monitor -u and wait a few seconds. You will get a link back which contains all the uploaded information. Provide this link when asked for. The second tool is Armbian Config, which allows you to adjust various board settings, install various software packages, or freeze kernel updates. It is mostly designed for new and inexperienced users. If you are an advanced user, you don't have to use it. You can find more information about everything in the official documentation, which you can find under docs.armbian.com. I will leave a link in the description below. If you do have questions or want to give feedback, you can ping me on IRC or in the forums. I'd love to hear what you're thinking. I'll provide links to both in the description below. This video is actually a collaboration between Nico D and myself, and I want to thank him for spending his time to put all the raw material that I provided together and bring it into good shape. Awesome job. Thanks for watching.